Hello everyone, I am Professor Nirendu Konar. I will be taking your semester 3 elective Advanced Business Analytics. Before I go into what will be covered in the subject, a little introduction about myself. I have done M.Tech from IIT Kharagpur and MBA from University of Phoenix, USA. I have 20 plus years of industry experience in companies like Steel Authority of India Limited, Mastek South Africa, AlphaSoft Services USA, Cisco Systems and Wipro Technologies. I have 7 plus years of teaching experience here in ICFI Business School. I teach information systems for managers in semester 1. Introduction to Business Analytics in Semester 2, Advanced Business Analytics in Semester 3, and Marketing Business Analytics in Semester 4. And sometimes I take Operations Management for Semester 2. I do industry consulting. My current consulting assignment is in healthcare domain, where I use artificial intelligence to automate healthcare solution. Now, coming to the subject Advanced Business Analytics, a detailed session wise plan is available in our LMS quick course, but here are few highlights of the course. We'll start with logistic regression and then we'll move into decision tree based ensemble methods like bagging, boosting, random forest, and then we will spend a good amount of time in deep neural networks and then advanced time series analysis. And for all these topics and many more which I have not mentioned here, for each topic we will have business cases and associated large data set, where we will be developing model to solve some business problems. You will be using R and Python, preferably both. The solutions to all the problems will be available in both the languages. I encourage you to be very proficient in Python because of industry demand today. But if you already know R and don't want to invest time to learn another language, R is also fine. But try to learn Python also. Now, what is driving business analytics? Why business analytics has become so successful today and everyone is using analytics, advanced business analytics in the industry today? There are three factors. Number one is huge volume of data, mainly from internet and social media. Number two is the cheap storage. The storage cost has gone down drastically. If you remember, even 7-8 years back also, if you wanted to buy a pen drive, the cost was much more than it is today. So we not only have huge volume of data, we can store that data very cheaply today. And the third factor is the processing power or the compute power and the availability of cloud computing, where you can have unlimited processing power and the storage and all the IT resources which is required to analyze large volume of data. Now today, the state-of-the-art technology is known as deep learning. Deep learning is nothing but the deep neural network which we will cover in this course. Deep learning is a technology what people are using today to solve every kind of problem. Take it driverless car to Alexa or Siri Everywhere the underlying technology is deep learning. Now if you look at the graph, the amount of data versus performance, and there are four lines. The red one is for the traditional machine learning algorithm, and the other three are for neural network. The blue one for medium neural network, and the green one is for large neural network, which is nothing but deep learning. If you have very small amount of data, you see the performance gap is not much. But when you have large amount of data, the performance for traditional machine learning algorithm is becoming flat. But if we put more and more data, the performance is steadily increasing for deep learning, for the green line or the red or the blue line. So these particular findings, basically that amount of data is correlated with the performance of a machine learning algorithm, is not very new. And after these findings, that business enterprises have started using deep learning to solve all kinds of problems. We will discuss more about all this as we progress through the course. I'll stop here today.